media on the line.
Good afternoon. My name is Ron Schuler, and I'm Minister of Infrastructure for the Province of Manitoba. On behalf of our Premier Brian Pallister and our government, thank you all for joining us today. I'm here today to give an update on basin conditions and our water control structure operations. Our province has seen record low precipitation since September of 2020. In most of Manitoba's watersheds, which have led to well below normal to record dry soil moisture at some locations. In fact, most of our southern watershed, consisting of Manitoba, North Dakota, Minnesota, and Ontario, have had less than 5% of normal rainfall. The month of June normally has the highest precipitation rate for the year, which is then followed by July and then May. For the Red River Valley Basin, average precipitation for June is 104 millimeters. Last month, it was 62 millimeters. The average normal precipitation for July in the Red River Valley Basin is 85 millimeters. So far, we have received 12 millimeters. For May, we are down from 70 millimeters to 33.5 millimeters of moisture. The Assiniboine River Basin average normal precipitation for June is 92 millimeters. This year, we received 78 millimeters. The average normal precipitation for July is 68 millimeters. So far, 19 millimeters have been observed. May average is 60 millimeters. This year, we saw 36 millimeters. Flows and water levels are also below normal to well below normal in most of southern and central Manitoba rivers and lakes. Between September of 2020 and this July, most southern and central water basins received 200 to 250 millimeters less precipitation than normal for this time of the year. Dry conditions are forecasted to continue until fall of 2021. Most central and southern Manitoba rivers and streams show normal to much below normal flows for this time of the year. For instance, the average flow of the Red River at Emerson, Manitoba for this time of the year is 6,730 cubic feet per second, or CFS. Today, it is at 855 CFS. The Red River is the driest it has been since 1980. The average flow of the Assiniboine River at Headingley, Manitoba for this time of the year is 2,920 CFS. Today, it is at 472 CFS. The Assiniboine River is the driest it has been since 1961, keeping in mind flows are being affected by the operation of the Shellmouth Reservoir. If we did not have the Shellmouth Reservoir, those levels would be much lower. These dry conditions are also affecting our lake levels in Manitoba. In fact, Lake Manitoba is the driest it has ever been, dating back to 1923. Currently, Lake Manitoba is at 810.6 feet. This is the lowest it has ever been for this time of the year on record. Evaporation is the single greatest source of the decline. In fact, Lake Manitoba dropped 0.5 foot in the last month. Without any substantial rain, the prediction from our Hydrologic Forecast Center is that Lake Manitoba will continue to decline by 0.5 inch every week. Again, this is mainly due to evaporation. The Fairford River Water Control Structure, or Fairford Dam, is currently running at 1,050 CFS, which is only slightly higher than the minimum flow set by regulation at 800 CFS. the FRWCS, or Fairford Dam, must continue to flow at the northern tip of Lake Manitoba to keep the Fairford River and Lake St. Martin supplied with fresh, oxygenated water. Without this flow, the water in the Fairford River and Lake St. Martin could become stagnant and harm the aquatic life in those and other tributaries. An adjustment may have to be made to the Fairford control structure to lower it so to keep the minimum 800 CFS flowing as per provincial regulation. Lake Winnipeg, which is at 713 feet, is still within its operating level. Although Lake Winnipeg is also affected by evaporation, it is not as dramatic due to the size and depth of Lake Winnipeg as compared to Lake Manitoba. Lake St. Martin is at a historic low level for this time of the year, and at 796.5 feet is 1/2 foot below its optimal operating level. Lake Winnipegosis is at a historic low at 829.9 feet, which is below its 831 foot average level. Dauphin Lake is 854.6 feet, which is still within its operating level of 853 to 854.8 feet. Lake of the Prairies, or Shellmouth, is still within its operating level, and 200 CFS are currently being released to supplement the lower Assiniboine River water supply users. Lake Watapana, near Rivers, Manitoba, is at 1,536.2 feet, which is spot on to its operating level. The conduit is currently being run at minimal CFS. The Portage Diversion Reservoir is currently at the desirable level to provide a sufficient water supply for water intakes for licensed holders on the diversion. The La Salle River is currently very low, and pumps are currently operational, with major siltation complicating the situation. Manitoba Infrastructure is working with the arm of McDonald to find solutions to this issue. The arm of McDonald has placed restrictions on water use in their rural municipality. They're currently at a stage three restriction level, which includes no yard sprinkling, no washing down of sidewalks or other outdoor services, and no washing of motor vehicles under most circumstances. Our government understands that the dry conditions are a major challenge for the agriculture industry and for Manitobans. And our government is working with industry and other levels of government on how we can be of assistance to impacted producers. Manitoba Infrastructure's role consists of operating and maintaining the provincial water control structures. To assist with current dry conditions, water control structures are being operated to mitigate low water level conditions. And I wish to reiterate again, the Fairford water control structure is being operated to balance the low level of Lake St. Martin and trying to maintain the minimum desirable flow at the Fairford River. The Shellmouth Dam is being operated to supplement water for the lower Assiniboine River water supply users while trying to maintain the desirable summer level for the upstream stakeholders for recreational use. Most water supply reservoirs have sufficient supply levels given the dry conditions, with the exception of Lake Minnewasta, the City of Morden's primary drinking water source, which is at 68% of full supply level. The City of Morden Council declared severe drought conditions on April the 8th and implemented water restrictions on May 4th, 2021. If dry conditions persist and strain continues on the rivers and reservoirs' water levels, the Minister of Agriculture and Resource Development can declare a serious water shortage under the Water Protection Act and issue an order to prevent, minimize, or alleviate the water shortage. Manitoba Infrastructure and the Department of Agriculture and Resource Development are closely monitoring conditions across the province and have continued meeting with department officials and stakeholder groups to seek input on how the province may be of further assistance. Thank you, and now for some questions.
Thank you, Minister. A reminder to our reporters on the line, we will have one question and one follow-up. Starting today from CBC Manitoba, Ian.
Good afternoon, Minister. Do you stand behind Premier Pallister's comments that the people who came to this country didn't mean to destroy anything?
Thank you, Ian. Our government is committed to advancing reconciliation that builds on meaningful engagement with residential school survivors, their families, Indigenous leadership, communities, elders, and knowledge keepers. This will help support the necessary process of healing and truth-telling on this important path forward.
Thank you. Can you say personally if you yourself support the Premier's comments?
Thank you for that question, Ian. And again, our priority is to engage with and listen to Indigenous leadership and their communities. There must be continued dialogue and sharing of knowledge that is graciously received from Indigenous leadership, elders, and survivors of residential schools through this dialogue.
From the Canadian Press, Steve.
Oh, hi, Minister. You mentioned the emergency measures available to you. Is the government prepared to invoke that? Do they envision those being invoked in the coming days?
At this point in time, there's no discussion on that. However, it is a tool that is available to us. The forecast is until fall that we probably won't be getting that much rainfall or precipitation, and that is worrisome. That would be a discussion that would happen within government and with our stakeholder groups. But at this point in time, it is not something that is being contemplated or discussed.
And I know you're not the minister for hydro or crowns, but obviously when you have this much drought, it can have a huge impact on Manitoba Hydro's bottom line and ability to export. We saw, you know, the drought of 2002, 2003 have a significant impact. Can you say what the government is looking at in terms of hydro's revenues and the revenues that generates for the province?
Yeah, I'll let the Minister of Crown Services address that issue when he feels that there's something that he should be reporting on. Today, what we're really talking about is the impact that we're going to have on our lakes. I know a lot of people love to go onto their lakes, especially this weekend. It's supposed to be really nice and sunny, and they're going to find it's going to be difficult getting, for instance, a boat into Lake Manitoba. A lot of our lakes are low. The fact that we dropped Lake Manitoba half a foot in 1 month is serious. It's substantial. So our comments today are basically reflective of that reality, just so Manitobans know as they go forward that we are in a serious low water situation. And as far as the other issues, that will be discussed later by other ministers.
From CTV, Danton.
Good afternoon, Minister. I'm wondering if you can give us an update on your vaccination status. Have you received your first or second COVID-19 vaccine dose?
Thank you for that question, Danton. I do not discuss my personal health information publicly.
All right. So you'd mentioned that if these dry conditions persist, the province can declare a serious water shortage. How close are we to that step?
I actually want to take this point in time to thank the officials within Emergency Measures Operation in the Department of Manitoba Infrastructure, the Deputy Minister and the leadership team, Ruth Eden, amongst others, who already in spring we were having the conversations about controlling the water levels, for instance, on Shellmouth and other areas where we hold water back. And we did so prudently. It was good leadership. It was visionary. We did the right things. So far, we're doing okay with our water in our control structures. We still have a considerable amount of water, as I laid out in my notes. Shellmouth is still doing really good. It's within its operating level. And so we still have water that we can release. We are having some problems with the Seine River, which is the Sel area, in regards to siltation, plugging up our machines. We're going to try to figure out other ways of getting water pumped over. We are working on it. So far, we don't feel we're there yet. However, if I can just give you two numbers, if you wouldn't mind. The problem is the way we started off the year. And in March, in the Assiniboine River, The average normal precipitation was 26 millimeters. The Assiniboine River Basin got 9. The Red River Basin normally had 25 millimeters. This year we got 6.1. So we started out really poorly. So that means that the ground is very dry. Even the rain that we've been getting, which we're very thankful for, we love that rain that we got, it was just absorbed by the ground. So there was no flow. So we're being very careful how we release those water flows. They're important to Manitobans. Our primary focus is potable water. We want to make sure that people still can live, drink, and do the household things that, you know, they need. So as states of emergency could be declared locally, you know, then watering your lawn, washing down the driveway don't become that important. Those then are not allowed. So we still believe that we have enough reservoir water. However, it is getting grim insofar as agriculture because we started out so dry that even a moderate amount of rain simply gets absorbed and it produces no flow in any of our waterways. I hope I answered your question.
Up next from the Winnipeg Free Press, Dylan.
Minister, we have readers saying that it's hypocritical that the government is asking everyone to roll up their sleeves or they can't access certain services, and yet there are people in cabinet who won't get a COVID shot or give an explanation for why they can't do so. How do you respond to that?
Thank you, Dylan. You've been very busy the last few days. My personal health information, however, is a private matter. Thank you.
Practically, how are you going to do your duties as minister here in this building and around the constituency if you aren't immunized?
Thank you for that question, Dylan, and I do not discuss my personal health information publicly.
Next Moving question. Now to the Brandon Sun and Kyle.
Good afternoon, Minister. What are you kind of hearing on the ground from agricultural producers in terms of the difficulties that they're having because of all this dryness and lack of precipitation?
I will allow the Minister of Agriculture to reflect on the conditions. However, I will say that certainly within my community and those that speak to us across the province, it's grim. The Interlake is terribly dry. And we see the effects of that just in our air quality. We've seen how the sun is basically blocked out because of all the smoke from forest fires. And our agriculture is struggling. Some areas did get a little bit of rain, and that helps because the crops do have quite a bit of leaf on it, and they're holding the moisture into the ground. But even there, it's very dry. And we will allow the Minister of Agriculture to lay out a little bit more. I understand this afternoon the federal minister is going to be in town and is going to be touring with the acting Minister of Agriculture. They'll be touring some of the agriculture areas, and probably be a good time to ask both of them even more definitive questions on where agriculture is right now. And I would suggest, I was on a call with the federal minister, Blair, and this is a problem across Western Canada and even into Eastern Canada. We're having a particularly dry year. And I would suggest to you and to everyone that we have to look at climate resiliency projects like the Lake Manitoba Outlet Channel. Last year, we had a 1 in 1,000 year rain event. This year, we're having historic low water events. And it just shows that we have to prepare ourselves. Europe, there's a huge criticism of governments in Europe that they are not investing in climate resiliency projects. And that's what we are planning on doing. We would call on the federal government and our Indigenous partners. The province has moved heaven. Let us now move earth on some of these climate resiliency projects like the Lake Manitoba, Lake St. Martin Outlet Channel. Because you know full well, we're talking today about lack of water. Tomorrow or in a year, we could be talking about flooding again. That was more than $2 billion flood. We better start looking at and investing in climate resiliency projects. To deny that is at our own peril. Thank you.
Thank you.
And if there are no follow-ups, this concludes today's media briefing.
Thank you all.